everybody. I'm Corinne Blackstone, and welcome to my craft room. I'm so happy to have you here today. In today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to take a picture like this and how to turn it into a cuttable SVG like this. It's a lot easier than you think, and it's super, super fun, so I can't wait to show you how to do it. I'll link all the websites and all the products that I'm using down below in the video's description, so it's super easy for you to find what you need in order to make your own. If you have any questions, you can always put those in the comments down below. I'm always happy to answer those for you. Let me know if you've ever done this before, and let me know if you're excited to try it as well. Before we get started, be sure that you're subscribed here, that way you don't miss out on any of the fun, crafty content we have coming. Without further ado, let's get started. So here in Remove.bg, we can drag and drop our image over here into where it says upload image or drop a file. I'm going to use a picture of my cat Waffles, and I'm just going to drag it and drop it. Now, it might take it a second to load into your software and get rid of your image, but your image is now gone. This is actually part of her body, so it's fine. We can leave that. And I'm going to click download, and I'm just going to download the preview for free. I'm going to save this into my YouTube folder for my pick to SVG and click save. Now, I want to go to pngtosvg.com. Next, you'll head to picsvg.com. And what I'm going to do is choose upload image or upload a picture. And I want to choose that picture with the background removed. So we're going to use this waffles removed background, and it will load into your picsvg.com. Now, it does look a little bit kind of like missing stuff in this one. So what I want to do is I'm going to change it to strong details. And then you can kind of play around with the different settings to see if you find one that's going to work for the way you want it to look. And this is like exactly kind of what I want, is edge 4, but let's go ahead and just kind of play around with it. Definitely not the internals. Definitely not that one. So definitely not the internals. Edge 4 I think is our best, but I'm also going to take the details and just change them down to great and just see if I like that one a little bit better. And I honestly think this one is a little bit more of like what I want to do with the design. From here, all I do is click download SVG, and again, I'll just save it into that folder. Now, over in Cricut Design Space, we simply click upload, and then we can choose the upload image option and browse for our design. I want to make sure that I select my SVG, which for me shows as a Microsoft HTML document. Go ahead and select that, and you'll see your image. Now, I do want to point out that this does look a little bit blurry right now, but don't worry, it won't be so blurry when you finish uploading. I'm going to go ahead and just give my image a name. I'm going to call it Waffle SVG, and then you can tag it with whatever you want. You can tag it like with different words, whatever you want to say that will help you search for it like in the future. Up to you, you don't have to do that. And then click upload. It's gonna put it right into your Cricut Design Space. And then from here, you can size it and we can use it for whatever we want to do. So I'm gonna make this bigger. I'm gonna actually put this, I think, on a tote bag, because I think that would be really cute, just to have her like little face on a tote bag. So I wanna make this a little bit bigger. So I think I'm gonna go like 10.785 is probably good. But one thing I want to point out before I do anything else, I'm going to go ahead and save my project really quick so I can hit make. I'm going to just save it as Waffles. That's her name. And I'm going to go ahead and click the make button and show you why we have to do something, because if we don't, it's going to be a mess. So if I were just to do it as it is, look at this disaster of a design. It's insane. There's pieces everywhere. Like nothing's where it belongs. So let me show you how you fix that. With these SVGs, they come grouped versus like as one single piece. Now there's a couple ways to fix this. You can select your entire design and you can attach it. So you can draw like a big square around it, or just select this and use the attach option. Or if you know you're never gonna change it, you're never gonna get rid of any of the details or anything, you can go down to combine and you can unite it or weld it, and that just makes it one single layer. And that's the way I prefer to do it, just because then I never have to worry about it being all these bunches of layers and anything getting messed up. Now I'm gonna go ahead and click save again, just so that it saves that welded project. And I can click the make option. Now when I do it, you'll see it's all on the one page. It's all where it belongs, and we're going to be ready to get this all done. Now, I know you guys sometimes complain that it's hard to see if I leave it black, so let me change the color really quick so that it might be a little easier for you to see over on the make screen. But this is what we're cutting out. We're cutting out this image. Now, I will say that weeding these can be quite the adventure, so I do recommend that when you're weeding them, you have the image pulled up, and I'm going to show you a quick little trick that I use to help me know how to weed this and like the right way to weed it. So what I'll do is after I have cut it and I'm ready to weed, I'm going to go ahead and change the color of my canvas. And I usually change it to something really shockingly different than what the image is. The reason I do this is it makes it very easy for me to see the parts of my image that need to be removed versus the parts that need to stay. So I need to remove anything that shows as a red piece, and anything that shows as a blue piece will be what stays on my mat or on my HTV, because we're going to cut this with HTV. Now I'm going to cut this on the everyday iron-on setting, and I'm going to be using some StarCraft Softflex for this. It's my favorite HTV. I think it cuts really well, and we'll be using our Cricut Maker for this. So let's go ahead over to the machine and get this cut out. I'm going to be cutting this with a brown HTV. This is StarCraft Softflex. I cut this on the everyday iron-on setting, and I make sure that it's mirrored. I'm going to go ahead and load this, let this cut out, and then we will weed it. I'd run 1,000 miles if I could run with you. Now, before I unload, I do always want to just double check my cut setting. Now, remember, I said it's hard to know where to weed. So for this, I know for a fact I can weed a little spot way down here at the bottom. So I'm just going to check that and make sure that it peels away really easy. And I'm just going to kind of check a few little pieces because I just don't trust this blade that's in this maker. I just don't think it's very good, but I think it's fine. So we're gonna go ahead and unload. I'm gonna trim this down, and then I'm gonna let you guys watch me weed. Tote bag, and I want to just pre-press it to get the wrinkles out and any moisture that might be in it out. So I just press it while the press is heating. Like once it's about 330 or more, or 230 or more, I can just press it, and I'll just do like a full 10 second press on it. That'll get out any of that moisture and any of those wrinkles to ensure that our HTV will stick really nicely, and that way we've got a nice surface. And then you can look kind of under here and see if there was like any moisture. There was a little bit in the bag, not too much, but it's always a good idea to do that. Now this type of material, this canvas, does hold a wrinkle pretty well, so if it's still a little bit wrinkly, you can always repress it if you want to. Really up to you. Now that the press is heated up, we can put our design on. Now the nice thing with this design is if it's not fully straight, it's not going to be super noticeable because it's kind of, you know, a little bit cattywampus in the design anyways. Got a little bit of dog hair on that. Let me just get that off. Now what we'll do is we're going to press this, and this again presses at 285 degrees for about 8 to 10 seconds. This product is a warm or hot peel product, so as soon as it's done pressing, you can remove your carrier sheet, and now you have your little picture that you made into an SVG cuttable. I'll show you what this looks like a little bit closer up. This is seriously so cute. I can't get over it. And I can't wait to use this for like my groceries and all sorts of fun things. But I hope that you guys saw how easy it was to take a picture and turn it into an SVG. It's very, very simple to do, and it's a lot of fun. Now you may need to play with a little bit of those settings, but I think you're gonna end up with a great image. And of course, don't forget to attach or weld your design before you hit make, or you're gonna have a big mess on your hands. This is such a great thing that you can do. These make great gifts, especially for like pet memorial gifts. I use them for that a lot. So if you're looking for something, this would be a perfect idea for that. Now, if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments down below. I'm always happy to answer those for you. Be sure that you're subscribed here on YouTube. That way you don't miss out on any of the fun, crafty content that I post. And if you're looking for any specific tutorials or you have a specific question about anything craft related, let me know in those comments and I'd be happy to help you out. I hope you all have a wonderful day. And as always, happy crafting.